all, a quick reminder that a refugee is a person with a well-founded fear of being persecuted for reasons of race, religion, nationality, for membership to a particular social group or political opinion. This comes from the Refugee Convention that was adopted in the 50s. This is very important to understand that when a person comes to a country that has signed this convention, he or she has the right to apply for asylum. It doesn't matter if he's undocumented. That's something very important to understand in the issue of the refugee integration. For the broad picture in Europe, as you probably, most of you know, that there has been an increase in migratory flows due to many factors in around the world, but particularly in Europe. Some of these factors are economic and political instability in several countries of nearby regions, particularly in the Middle East, inequality between the developed and developing countries, increase in the world's population versus the decreasing and aging population in Europe, and reduced transport and communication costs. Now, the answers to these increasing migratory flows from the European Union and more broadly throughout Europe has been very inconsistent. So on the one hand, we have this tendency to opening doors between among the countries in the European Union. So there has been a tendency to have the borders sort of invisible from one country, for example, from Spain to France. But on the other hand, we have this tendency to securitization. So there has been the external board, the European Union has emphasized the security of external borders of the EU with other countries that are not Europe, so Asia, Africa, and so on. This is an example of this tendency, of the last tendency that I talk about securitization. This is the EU funding that goes to Bulgaria for migration and home affairs. So as you can see in this graph, more than 80% of this funding goes to security, either for border issue or for police issues, and only 12% of this funding, which is 80 million total, goes to asylum and migration and integration. So the tendency is, you can see with the numbers, and this comes from the European Commission website. Now, the particular context of Bulgaria and migration, it's important to know that, to understand that Bulgaria was under the influence of the Ottoman Empire until the early 20th century. And then in the 40s, Bulgaria fell in the influence of the Soviet Union. And it was not until the 90s that it has the first multi-party election. There was a freely multi-party election in Bulgaria. And then later in 2007, Bulgaria was a member of the European Union. It is situated in southeastern Europe and it has borders with a variety of countries, including Greece and Romania and Serbia. And then it has a border with a non-European country or European Union country, which is Turkey. And this is particularly important to understand because Bulgaria is one of these countries that is an outside border of the European Union, which means that under the Dublin Convention, through the European Union, when a person first enters in a European Union country, he or she is bounded to apply to asylum in that country, which means that if someone comes from Turkey and to Bulgaria, and he's the first country in the European Union he steps in, he has to apply there. He cannot go to Germany to apply for asylum. So this is important in the Bulgarian context because it's one of the main reasons why there are so many people applying for asylum in this country. So you come from Turkey. The second issue that is important to understand in the context of migration is that in Bulgaria is that traditionally Bulgaria has been a country of emigration rather than immigration. So during the last decades, there has been an important part of the Bulgarian population that has actually left the country to look for opportunities in other Western countries rather than the opposite, rather than having immigrants coming to Bulgaria. And actually, even today, most of the, most of the refugees that are in Bulgaria see Bulgaria as a transit country. So they stay there until they get asylum, or sometimes not even that, and then go to, they continue their trip to a Western European country.